This is a basic, that is the wisdom which I have inside to be revealed outside is through our expressions. It, that is a true wisdom. Okay, and I was just thinking about the fear of God. Fear of God is the beginning of wisdom. In fear of God, the first condition is 34:11, what it says, keep your tongue from evil. Away from evil. Psalm 34:11, it says, keep your tongue away from evil. From evil only. 34:13. Keep your tongue from evil. The first thing. The next thing is, your lips from speaking lies. The next is, turn from evil and do good. Seek peace and pursue it. Okay, the first part we have learned today. Before this, I thought I should share one more thing. The difference between fear of God and fear of man. What is the difference between fear of God and fear of man?
Slow to anger.
Slow to anger. And generally this one. We can take the life of Jacob. He was afraid of his brother. What he did?
He saw.
He was not able to stand in front of his brother. Suppose if I fear God, what I do, whatever may be this thing, I just go fall flat in the God's presence and surrender. God, forgive me, I have sinned against you. Please treat me, accept me as your child. So fear of man makes me to run away. Fear of God makes me to come closer to God. The second example?
Jonah.
I have taken from Peter.
Okay.
Okay. What Peter does, when he was fearing people, he was denying Christ in the crowd. But at the same time, when he started fearing God, he was the first person to proclaim about God. Fear of God will make you to proclaim about God. Fear of man will make you to this thing, to deny. And one more thing, Jonah, you say?
Yes.
What is it?
In the book of Jonah, he tried to run away from God.
Yeah.
Despite God's direct order to speak to the city of Nineveh. But eventually he did come.
He ran away, na? When God...
On a boat.
Why he ran away? That is because of fear of man. That is also fear of man.
Fear of man. Okay.
Then yeah. God, when God intervened in his life, he came back to do his work, God's work.
Yes.
Then one more thing I can say. Fear of God will make us to run away from sinful things. But fear of man will make us to do sinful things. Example, revenge, killing, destroying others. This is fear of man. Fear of God, it makes us to think and asks us to go closer to God, ask for forgiveness, to run away from all things which doesn't please God. See, these are constructive things. And everything begins with a small part of our body, which is the tongue, which doesn't have bone, but it always tries to boast and it always tries to destroy ourselves. And we have to just remember this word, the tongue has the power to of life and death. Whoever will eat its fruit. That's what the scripture says. And it goes on. If time permits, next week we will think about the next another three things, which is the first thing is keep your tongue from evil. The next is keep your lips from telling lies. The third thing is turn from evil and do good. And the fourth thing is love peace and pursue it. Seek peace and pursue it. So these are the four things which we can understand are the signs of fearing God. Once we fear God, the God's wisdom comes into us. That is the beginning of wisdom. Once the wisdom comes inside, your total expression, the words, the relationship, the communication, the thought which we have about ourselves also changes. I'll just mention one more word about the fear of God. Proverbs 8:13. It says, fear God is to hate evil. Proverbs chapter 8 verse 13, it says,
"The fear of the Lord is to hate evil, pride and arrogance and the evil way and the perverse mouth I hate."
See, if you see here, it says, the fear of God, we are just discussing, fear of God is the beginning of wisdom. And one of the signs of fear of God is to hate evil. And again, now it doesn't stop there. Again it says, I hate pride, I hate arrogance, I hate evil behavior, I also hate perverse speech. And the previous word in verse 12 we see, I, wisdom. Wisdom introduces itself. I, wisdom, dwell together with prudence. I possess knowledge and discretion. Then it says, to fear God is to hate evil. Not, it doesn't stop there. It says, I hate pride, I hate arrogance, I hate evil behavior, I hate perverse speech. And then if you go further, it says, what are the signs of wisdom? So counsel, sound judgment are mine. I have understanding, I have power. By wisdom, kings reign. By wisdom, rulers makes law that are just. So it goes on. So we who worship the living God, who think ourselves that we are the children of God, we who every day almost we sing songs to God and praise God, always we have to be very careful before using our tongue, before using the words, before. And another thing is also there, which we have to always remember, out of the fullness of your heart, your mouth speaks. If my heart is filled with God's love, God's words, God's attitude, then my mouth speaks what are all the things related to God. And God's command is this, love your neighbor as yourself. Your neighbor is the people who are coming across in our lives, in our day-to-day activities. So we have to show love. If you are showing love, it's nothing but through your words and actions. And it all starts from meditating the word of God.
Will you shoot me? Just hold it, please. It's a very nice get-together. Tongue has two purposes. First purpose is to praise the Lord, to speak about the scriptures. That is the first divine use of the tongue. Second purpose is also to taste the food which has been offered to the Lord. Because if food is offered to the Lord, it becomes divine. So these two are the main purposes of the tongue. Otherwise, tongue is used in worldly sense, and then it may speak nonsense, it may eat nonsense and all that. So, you know, according to Vedic belief, tongue has two purposes. One is holy names, chant it, taste holy prasadam, blessed food. That's it.
Thanks.